Hi, and welcome back to episode 2 of Star Trek Online. Two quick points. I've done some messing about with the settings. It might be better or not, we'll see. One of the things I've done is to change the settings on my picture-in-picture camera to 720 by 1080. And actually, I need to move that camera slightly. I'm hoping that that will give a slightly better definition in the picture down the bottom left-hand corner, because the last time I realized when I put this up at 1080, it was horrible looking. Second thing is, I did some looking into using an Xbox controller with this game. There's a lot of key binding, and I am going to do it just purely because I think it would be fun to play this game in that way, but not today. It's going to take me a few hours work to get it working, because I don't fully understand what I'm doing with it and I need to look it up. So that's everything. Right, on with the show. We are supposed to go and investigate the going quiet of our the Kittimer. Yeah.
We're here, Captain. The USS Kittimer is dead ahead, and the Renown is beside us. Our orders are to make contact with the Kittimer and find out why they've not responded to our hails.
Very good. Set a course for Kittimer. For the Kittimer. Okay. You just know we're about to get ganked.
Yes, sir. I will require approximately 15 seconds to make the necessary adjustments.
Oh, yay! We're gonna be sitting ducks!
Captain Bullock. Captain Taggart? What are you both doing here?
Let Captain Volok explain the situation. I'm the junior officer.
We attempted to inform you that the Renown would be escorting these cadets back to Earth's space dock, but we were unable to establish a subspace link. I thought it prudent to investigate.
I'm relieved to see both of you. The anomalies must be interfering with our communications. Where is Captain Taggart?
Explain what happened, let Captain Volok explain.
That's quite the story, Cadet. I'm sorry to hear about Captain Taggart. He was one of the best officers in Starfleet. I'm sure this isn't easy for you and your crew. Don't worry, we'll have you back at Earth Space Dock before you know it.
Okay, very quickly go into audio. No, it's actually the same as it was. That's really weird. It's so loud on my headphones. Oh well. Listen.
I'm troubled by the anomalies in this system. And if they're affecting long-range communications, then they're doubly a cause for concern. Let's do this by the numbers. We've already launched 9 probes. Now that they're active, we can do an in-depth scan of the anomalies. With all 3 ships collecting data, we should be able to complete this quickly and formulate a course of action. The Renown has the largest science team, so I recommend we send our data there for analysis. Any questions?
No questions, sir. I'm confident that my crew is up to the task.
You're quite confident for a cadet. You remind me a bit of myself when I was an ensign. Of course, I wasn't commanding a ship back then. Let's see how you perform before you start claiming that chair full time.
Alrighty.
You can set your ship's power levels to have a focus on attack, defense.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna go with speed. Go, Speed Racer! Go, Speed Racer! Go, Speed Racer! Go! Okay. Is that right? That's wrong. What am I supposed to be doing here?
Reports indicate traces of gamma radiation, but there's something off in the readings.
Yeah, it's gonna be Klingons. Or Romulans. Or Cardassians. Or Iconians, considering this is the Iconian War. Alrighty, come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Let's get there.
Kittimer here. Are you seeing the same gamma radiation levels that we are? I'm not sure that a normal scan will be enough. We might need to do a full multiphasic reading. My chief science officer, Commander Davis, suggests that performing a reverse tachyon pulse wave scan will solve our sensor issue. Perform your final scans and then report back.
Reverse tachyon pulse wave scan. Perfect World, I commend you on your use of technobabble. Okay. Okay, we are going to get ganked. I know we're going to get ganked. It's so obvious that we're going to get ganked. This is going to be painful. Okay, and we're just about there. And where's the scan?
Deflector dish is realigned for reverse tachyon pulse wave, sir. Picking up a transwarp signature. It's right on top of us! The Borg!
Warning. Ship is lower your shields and prepare to be boarded. All life forms will be assimilated.
Okay, I didn't think of the Borg.
Target's shield has failed.
The Kittimer is under attack. Use full impulse to reach her quickly.
Come on.
Activate full impulse by clicking on the arrow.
Yes.
Deactivate full impulse.
I know! Gods, let me get there! Oh, I'm gonna hit you so hard, your grandkids are gonna have bruises. So tough. So badass.
This is the emergency medical hologram aboard the USS Kittimer. I am requesting assistance from any Federation vessel in range. I've lost contact with the bridge. I am unable to contact Commander Davis for new instructions.
EMH, give me a situation report.
The Kittimer is being overwhelmed by Borg boarding parties. These Borg are different than the ones in my history records. They seem disconnected somehow. They're strange, but still quite dangerous.
Can you hold out on your own? We have problems of our own to deal with.
I am an emergency medical hologram, not a miracle worker.
Leonard H. McCoy fan service! Yeah! In case you wondered, my favorite character from the original series is McCoy, Leonard H. If you've never had a chance to, there's a book called Doctor's Orders. I highly recommend it. Captain Volok, what should we do?
The Borg were brutally efficient on the Kittimer. The emergency medical hologram may be in command simply because no one else is fit to do so. The Borg have not been seen in the Alpha Quadrant in decades. Their arrival cannot simply be a coincidence. However, I hesitate to speculate without the full data from all of the probes.
What do you need us to do?
I will send teams to aid the Kittimer. You will have to finish the scans. We need to know the extent of the Borg presence here. You must also inform me if you or your crew are unable to continue. The Borg evoke a strong emotional response. They can rattle even trained Starfleet officers. A crew of cadets that have already survived a Klingon attack may be unable to cope.
Good idea, Flo. I'm torn. I mean, let's face it, Pinkskins. I'm Andorian. You know, a rough and tumble blue-skinned race who enjoy insulting everyone, Pinkskins. So, do I go with, I trust my crew will get the job done, which is kind of a little bit adversarial and thus highly Andorian? Or do I go with, good idea, Florist. Good idea, Florist, what is our status? You know, which is very Starfleet cadetish. I don't know. Ah, balls to it.
I have linked the Iota point to your map. Scan there while we see to the Kittimer.
Yeah, why do I get the feeling I'm going to be seeing to them as well? Ah, oh, come on. I'm there.
Please transmit the data so we may begin our analysis.
There's going to be more Borg.
We have your data, and our science team is analyzing it now.
What is the status of the Kittimer?
Our tactical teams have eliminated the Borg boarding parties on the Kittimer. Why do you ask?
Can we use the Kittimer to help analyze the data?
There's an 88.47% chance that you will need my help.
I'm suddenly having second thoughts about this. I'm so tempted. No, agreed. We can you help the Renown analyze data we've accumulated?
I have 75 million gigaquads of computer memory and an extensive library of files on military tactics and command strategies. I believe I can spare a few bits of processing power for you.
Holy shit.
Borg transwarp signatures detected. Prepare your ship for combat.
They're firing. I need help.
Come on. Goodbye. Can I just say that this generation of Starfleet vessels are hard as frickin' nails? Hang on, did they just destroy one of the ships? They destroyed.
More aboard! I don't know if we're ready for this.
Yeah, we are. They're pussies! By which I mean they're flexible and hard and are really able to take a pounding. Come on. I need a rear torpedo.
Maintain your composure. Logically, you can defeat the Borg with Admiral Janeway's tactics. You are Starfleet officers. You are prepared for this.
Whoa.
Multiple Borg warp signatures detected.
Oh, great. Borg spheres.
It's an impatient force.
No, it's,
We're outnumbered. There's no way we can...
The Borg are departing, most likely for a more strategic target. Direct your fire at the remaining sphere. Focus your fire, and we shall prevail.
I need to try and get faster than its turning speed. That worked.
Direct hit.
Try about 20 of them, mate. Frickin' hell.
Here is the situation as we see it. The Borg are using the Pollock system as a staging area for a larger invasion. Long-range sensors are already detecting inbound transwarp signatures. The most likely target for a first strike is the Vega system. There is a civilian colony there, and if the Borg could take it by surprise, they would have large numbers of new drones at their disposal.
Tactical, the Charon should go to Vega to warn the colonists.
Very observant of you. The Renown is better equipped to hold off further Borg attacks and assist the Kittimer. We must remain here. Once you have warned the colony, return to Earth's space dock.
Can you stop the Borg?
This is not a matter of can, Cadet. It is a matter of must. We must buy you as much time as possible. Once we are no longer in a position to help, we will stage a tactical retreat. You should have enough time to warn the colony. I will attempt to summon additional ships to assist, but you cannot wait for them to arrive.
Understood. We'll set a course.
Most missions can be turned in remotely. Click the icon next to the mission to report to the contact and turn in the mission.
It is imperative that you warn the colony at Vega of the impending attack. We will do what we can to hold off the Borg here in Vega and repair the Kittimer. Live long and prosper.
Sure, pointy ears. Holy crap, that's a really good reward. I mean, for this level, this is a really, really good reward.
We have to make our way to Vega as soon as we can, Captain. I just hope we're not too late to warn the colony. Are you ready to go?
Almost. I've skill points to spend, goddammit. Should just turn that off. Here we go. I don't have any attack patterns, so there's not really much point to that. Evasive maneuvers is kind of awesome, but I have to say, I don't really end up using this evasive maneuvers in this game for evading. I actually use it to turn very quickly to bring my foot on torpedoes to bear. It's very good for that. Let me see. Well, for a start, I have some ground ones, so I think we can go weapon proficiency, even. Personal shield generator. That's a lieutenant commander skill, so... Oh, is that it? Okay, that's it. Never mind. Right. This will improve weapons power by plus 10. I'm not going to go to the red, but we will use that. I think we don't have attack patterns, but we'll use... No, we won't use that. What we will do, though, is we will improve our driver coil. Accept. Nice. Go away. Inventory. Character? Where is... Ah, there it is. Okay, we already have nothing of interest. So that is a photon torpedo launcher, standard one. This one does improved damage and much higher crit damage, so that's fine. I don't want to trade it. This can go in here. You definitely go in there. I'm fine with that. Deflector array. Hang on. Okay, that's the impulse engine, right? Shield emitter amplifier. So that goes into here. Which is cool because that gives us a nice improve to our shield regeneration. I like that. Now, we have a deflector and it's crap. So this improves our sensors, our inertial dampeners, and our power insulators. Yeah. Okay, that's in. And I think... Now, I need to bring up my character. Okay, whatever. Wow. Okay, so apparently they've changed the way you organize your non-player characters. Okay, where's the status for her. Oh, there we go. Nice. Okay. Split beam rifle. I actually prefer those. Okay. We are going to be bringing her, so she gets a new boomstick. Right. Replicator. Recycle. Now, this is where things get awesome, because you can... I have nothing that currently that I can recycle, because you can see it doesn't give me anything. Energy credits being the case. You use energy credits to replicate items that you need for various missions or, well, like frequency remodulator. It's a common ground device. Medical supplies, which are used for various types of missions. It's quite a cool system. Right, ops.
We have to make our way to Vega as soon as we can, Captain. I just hope we're not too late to warn the colony. Are you ready?
Yeah, whatever. Depart the system.
Shields up, red alert.
Holy shit. Yeah, there's no way they survived that. Why am I taking damage? Why am I taking damage? Okay, so we're going to the Vega system, which is... map. We are... here somewhere, so we're gonna need to go to the Vega system, path course. Now, the driver coil, basically, by improving your driver coils, you improve your warp and impulse performance. In this case, I increased my warp speed, maximum warp speed, to 5.2 from 5. It's not inconsiderable, generally speaking. I mean, it's worth using. I have a feeling it also affects maneuvering speed to some degree, but I'm not certain. I'm going to shut off the astrometrics. That's kind of annoying. Okay, whatever. Actually, I would like to sit down and find out how accurate this is in relation to the actual mapping of the known galaxy, as in, are the light distances accurate? Be quite curious. Begin assimilation of the innocents. The Vega system was one of the earliest star systems to be colonized by humans after the development of spaceflight, and the colony of Vega 9 has been a key point on trade routes since the 22nd century. With the automation of Vega 9's massive cargo depots in the mid-23rd century, the planet's population turned from industrial concerns to other pursuits. One of these is the exploration of Delton runes on the planet that may be able to tell Federation archaeologists about early space exploration. Delton. I wonder are those the... I need to look that up. I think they might actually be the bald... Remember the bald one from the motion picture? More than 2.8 million Federation citizens currently reside on Vega 9, many in smaller settlements spread across Temperate Zone. Vega 9 is proud to send more than a dozen of its young people to Starfleet Academy each year. Cool. Okay.
We arrived before the Borg. Now my heart can start beating again. What are your orders, Captain?
Hail the colonies, we have to warn them.
Tavril managed to establish a comm link with Willa Post, the administrator of Vega Colony. It's not a great signal, but it's the best we're gonna get. Putting her through now.
Greetings, Captain. Is there something I can do for you today?
The Borg are on their way to the system. You need to start evacuating.
Repeat, please. Your signal is breaking up. Did you say the Borg? What about them?
The Borg are on their way. Mayor, you have to evacuate. What just happened?
I have lost contact with Vega Colony, sir. Something is blocking all subspace signals in this area. Even our hails to the civilian ships are not getting through. There is a communication satellite nearby. It should boost our signal sufficiently to inform the freighters of the danger and warn the colony.
Set a course. Okay, it's right in front of me. I do not need to set a course. It's kind of annoying, actually. By the way, this episode could cut out randomly because there is a scheduled server takedown, and I'm not actually sure when it is. I know it's Pacific Standard Time, but, well, frankly, I have problems with time zones. Here we go.
Our hails are still blocked, sir. The Borg may be attempting to isolate the planet before they land. Your orders, sir.
There's 2.8 million of them. Fucking hell. Zarva, can we get a transporter locks on the cons? 2.8 million and it's a Miranda-class starship. The hell?
Borg are jamming up any remote signals. It's not safe to beam through that. I think I can boost the gain, though.
Hurry, I think the Borg will be here any, and here they come. Oh, boy. Actually, I'm going to go after this one first.
Those civilian ships are right in the Borg's path. We have to help them.
Target shields have failed.
One down. Do you remember when the Borg were ridiculously hard-ass and... And that's pretty much what I use evasive maneuvers for. Really fast, sprightly maneuvering to get my foot on torpedo to bear. And it works.
Target shield has failed.
Goodbye. Seriously? Reinforce that shield. Next, you. First you will know pain. No, first you will know fear, then you will know pain, then you will die. Now, I think you can see why this is my favorite part of this game. I love space combat in this game. It actually feels like Star Trek. Reduce speed. I wasted that. That was a mistake! Okay, next one.
Target shields have failed.
Actually, it might not have wasted it. That looks good. Okay, there's one more here. Sometimes it's worth slowing down because it's very easy in this game to overshoot.
Warning. Ship is under attack. Target's shields have failed.
Okay, that's it. They are dead. They're dead, Jim. That looks like a Borg sphere.
Captain, I have short-range communications. Long-range signals are still blocked. I can contact the planet and have informed Administrator Post of the situation. However, the Borg have already landed and are moving toward the colony. It may be more prudent to retreat back to the Renown, sir.
I'll be right back. Sorry about that. Front door, as always. Okay, so what do we do? We have to make our stand here, cadet. Look for any Borg landing parties. We're the only Starfleet vessel in the system. We'll rescue as many colonists as we can. No. Making our stand. Okay.
Borg landing craft detected nearby. Captain, there are civilian ships engaging them.
I believe I can send a message to those ships.
Come on.
Sir, Civilian ships, you are ordered to disengage and retreat. We will cover you.
Roger that, Starfleet. All ships, pull back.
Target shields have failed.
All civilian ships have safely warped out the system, Captain.
One down. In the ground. Ooh, I seem to have taken a little bit of damage.
Target's shields have failed.
Oh, this is bad. This is very, very, very bad. Worried about the assimilation probes, but I'm very worried about these guys. Okay, I get... I do get the reason why they're making you feel like a badass by making you go against the Borg single-handed and... Yeah, you know, you're kicking ass and taking numbers. It's cool. Don't get me wrong. But there's no way a Miranda class should survive against the Borg. Just a little bit of speed so I can actually turn. Goodbye. Okay, that's the fourth one. There's the fifth one? Where's the fifth one? I don't get it. Ah, there it is.
Warning. Ship is under attack. Target's shields have failed.
The reason I'm kind of bothered by it is that... I just destroyed more Borg ships in the last half hour than...
Captain, the Borg have landed, and the colony won't be able to hold them off for long. I recommend beaming down to Vega and getting as many people out as we can.
I've just destroyed more Borg ships in this mission than Starfleet did in all the movies and television series.
Choose your away team for your next mission. Your choices for who will be on your away team will grow as you recruit more bridge officers.
Yay, all two of us. We're screwed.
Captain, according to our readings, over half the planet is already assimilated by the Borg. At the rate they're progressing, the region we're in will be overrun in roughly 1 hour. And if that wasn't bad enough, the interference is affecting the ship's transporters. No, sir. I'll follow your lead.
Okay. Pause zone. As you can see, you can actually pause the zone. It only gives you a few seconds to assign your, to assign what you want to do. So basically, it gives you a chance to give your individual away team members a order to do something specific. It's an interesting system, and it's much better than what they had originally, which I seem to recall was, oh, I've paused it, and I can leave it paused.
That's one of those Borg ships from orbit. Are we too late? Those landing ships don't just carry drones. They can pump nanoprobes directly into the ground and the atmosphere. We need to hurry. The Borg will be in this area soon.
Okay, that's the first one's tagged, and we're going to get attacked. We are going to get ganked by the Borg. You can see the pause zone going up. That's the longer you go without pausing, the longer you get to make your decisions. It's a really, really interesting system, and it's good fun too. Okay. Here we go. Okay. Talk to refugee.
Thank you. We didn't know if anyone from Starfleet got our distress signal, and we don't have any weapons. But we do have some spare armor suits for you and your officer. They're in the crates next to the gate. This code will open the gate. Please, Administrator Post and some of the others are still there. You have to save them.
Take the armor from the crate and then open the gate. Yep. Inventory and... take all. Nice.
Press the U key. This is your character.
Whatever.
Here you can see your...
Yes, I know, I know, I know. Okay, so it's... plus 10, plus 10. They're identical, so that's cool. And Miss Flores gets body armor. I'm really glad I gave her that rifle at this point, because this could have been unpleasant.
Oh no, we're too late.
Oh, well that was unpleasant. Did we get her in time? Or him? Or it? Can I do anything? Okay, that's them. Very rude people standing right outside my window. How dare they? Come on! Okay, so we tag these guys and oh, come on. Okay, they got that one. You can see why I like the splitter phaser. It's a good solution to area of effect. Oi, stop running! God damn it. New respawn point unlocked. Nice. Okay. Love me some flanking maneuvers. Oh yeah. Stay back or what? Okay, he's going to be our next crewman, I would guess. Okay. You going to follow us? What am I supposed to do? I don't get this. That's kind of annoying. I can't for the life of me figure out what I'm supposed to do. I guess we go back this way then. Oh, I bet you I missed one of the... yeah, I didn't beam these civilians out. That was what was wrong. Of course, this is probably going to end with us having...
we have the civilians. There is still no sign of the Renown or the Kittimer.
Chances are we're going to end up with Borg all over the ship. Which would be fun. Nothing says Star Trek like a Starfleet vessel overrun by the Borg.
I apologize for Koles putting a rifle in your face. If it wasn't for him, the Borg would have assimilated me by now. What's the situation? Are you bringing more Starfleet reinforcements?
We're the only ones here. The Charon is in orbit.
I see. Then it's true. Vega is doomed. A single starship cannot hope to stop this. Still, there is more to do. Many citizens are hiding in their homes. We cannot abandon them to the Borg.
We can rescue them, but something is blocking our transporters.
I know. Koles and I have been trying to get around the interference field. Thank you for tagging the people you found and getting them safely transported to your ship.
That can't be everyone.
No, there are dozens more hiding out in the buildings. But Koles and I have a plan. We think a pattern enhancer will do the trick. With that, we can transport the remaining citizens to your ship. But first, I'd like to offer you some equipment. Vega was a trade colony, and this gear was intended to go to Starbase 65. I think you need it more.
Well, you have my tanks, I'll retrieve the equipment and set up the pattern enhancer. Take. Okay.
You have received a kit appropriate.
Yeah, whatever. Okay, this gives me photon grenades. Oh, yes, thank you. Not that I use it very often, but...
You now have additional abilities in ground combat.
Yeah, I know. I just don't care. I really need to shut her off.
We have lowered shields for the transporter, sir. I will need to raise them at the first sign of Borg ships.
Ah!
The pattern enhancers are working, and not a moment too soon. I can hear the Borg moving. I'll do that. How long do you think you can hold off the Borg?
As long as we need to, give the signal. Alrighty, we're gonna get waves of Borg, I think. Yeah.
Remember when we thought fighting a crazed Klingon was the worst thing that could happen today?
Oh, fighting these aren't so bad.
Concentrate fire on the Borg. We need to keep them away from the civilians.
Nah, you think?
Another group of civilians has beamed to the ship, Captain.
Okay, we're halfway there. Actually, yeah, we're just over halfway there. That's not bad going. Come on. He's brave, but he's an idiot. Oh, he's gonna get killed. How do I throw a photon grenade? And we're done! That was easy.
Shields are back up, sir, but more Borg vessels are warping to our location. We have detected a type of generator near your position. There is a 94.6% chance it is the device affecting our transporters. If you can destroy it, we will transport as many people from the area as we are able.
And now you know, and knowing is half the battle. G.I. Starfleet! Okay, hang in there for Terrell, we'll be back. We'll be there soon. Mayor, thank you for your assistance. Get the fuck
thank
off
you
the
for
ship.
Everything you've done. Even though it was impossible to save everyone, those you did save will be forever in your debt.
I'm not finished yet.
Glad to do anything I can. I was born on Vega. There's no way I'm sitting by and letting the Borg take it without a fight.
Yeah, there's no way that voice is coming from that head. I'm sorry, there just isn't.
I know the drill. Just never expected any Borg here, you know.
Alright, call us. Yeah, okay. Obviously, somehow that dialogue didn't come out. It's kind of annoying. But oh well. Oh, crap. I did say I don't really use grenades very much.
I knew that one. We played poker last night.
Poker must be the unofficial game of the Federation at this point. It's kind of ridiculous. Guys? Anyone? Oh, how do I love being ignored by my crewmates? That's kind of annoying.
We are the Borg. Resistance is futile.
The Borg are activating the transport inhibitor.
That's fine.
We need to disable that force field.
No problem. I'm here to chew bubblegum and kick ass, and I'm all out of... Actually, no, I'm not.
The Borg are so... What's the word? Effective? Systematic? Evil. I'm gonna go with evil.
Come on. Okay. Gonna have to fight that one, and it's gonna be a special. Yay.
We are the Borg. Resistance is futile.
Then again, he might just be a wuss. Yeah, he's a wuss.
The ship is transporting anyone they can get a lock on, Captain, but we don't have much time. We need to get back as soon as possible.
Not just yet. I want to see... There's another red dot, and I'm wondering what it is. I'm kind of curious. Although it appears to have just gone. I really need to mess around with controls in this game, because it's kind of a little bit janky sometimes. Oh well. Alright, beam out.
The ship is transporting any...
Now, we're probably going to have to fight our way out of the system, and that'll be the end of this episode, because it'll also be the end of this mission.
We're packed to the brim with civilians, Captain. I don't think we could fit one more soul on this ship. Communications are still jammed, so we can't reach the Renown or the Kittimer. The immediate problem is the civilian ships in this system. Vega's a huge trading outpost. There are always ships traveling here. We need to warn them the Borg have taken over.
Can we reconfigure satellites in the system to send out a warning? To send an automated warning. Yes,
possibly, but what we need to do is hightail it out of here with these civilians. Of course, the path to the satellites does lead away from the planet, so we could remotely reconfigure them as we leave. The message won't get very far, but anyone who enters the system will get the signal and be able to turn around before it's too late.
Sounds like a solid plan, Helm. Lay in a course. We're gonna get ganked. Just saying it right now. We are gonna get ganked. Okay, come on. It's amazing what you can do with a beam.
Multiple probes inbound. I don't think the Borg like us hanging around.
You gonna fire?
Target shield
has failed. Oh, come on, shoot him. This is where not running around at full impulse is a good thing. It gives you time to actually turn and get a shot in and not accidentally maneuver past. Oh, that was unpleasant. Okay, they're going to... Oh boy, we might not survive this one. We actually might not survive this one, because Although, no, apparently our hull repairs as well. I didn't realize that. That's kind of cool. Okay, I'm just going to balance that for shields so that our shields... okay. It's about as good as it's going to get.
Never thought I'd wish I was back at the Academy studying for the astrometrics final.
Warning, ship is under attack.
From this time forward, your culture will adapt to service ours.
Oh, come on. Oh, this is really bad. This is really, really bad.
Sir, there are several fast-moving ships on sensors. No way to contact them, and I can't tell if they're friend or foe.
How much do I bet they're Klingons? Please let them be Klingon. I never thought I'd say that. There's something wrong with me. Actually, they're not going to be Klingons. I don't know who they're going to be, but we're probably moderately boned. Okay, balance. The mistake I made there was I left myself in defensive posture instead of going offensive, which would have given me a much better chance of winning.
Throw out your shields and prepare to be boarded.
Like hell!
A cube? Guess it's our time to go out in a blaze of glory.
Nope. Armitage, renown, defiant.
Exceptional effort.
I think it's time to rejoin the fleet. Come on. Drop those shields. Oh yeah. I might want to get the hell away from here really fast. Find the Kittimer and the Armitage. So we have an Akira, a Sovereign. I'm not sure what that is. Might be a Sovereign as well, actually.
We held off what we could in Pollux and sent a signal out to Starfleet. These were the closest ships. Others will be arriving as soon as they can.
Glad to see you. There's no way we could have defeated the cube by ourselves.
You have handled things well thus far. Excellent thinking on reconfiguring the satellites into warning beacons. We received the signal as soon as we arrived in the system.
Are we going to attempt to retake Vega?
I will be discussing that option with the other captains here, but your priority is to protect the civilians you have on board, as well as to ensure the safety of your crew. The Kittimer will return to Earth space dock with you. Once you arrive, report to Admiral Quinn. He will have more information for you.
Yes, sir.
You and your crew have done well. Koles would make a fine addition to your senior staff.
Oh, full auto rifle. Oh, yeah. I want it.
Congratulations, Lieutenant.
Captain Volok told us to get to Earth's space dock, and I think he's right. We need to get the civilians to safety. And I don't think I can handle any more excitement.
Okay, we will do that in a moment. First of all, I remembered you can overlay. Right, we have things and... Why don't I have any more what the hell? Oh, I probably need to be promoted. Yeah, that's probably the issue with that. Ship batteries, hull repair. Oh, is that it? That's all I can do. Okay. But I still have lots and lots free. Well, I don't have 513 free, but anyway. Okay, so we got a Neutronium Alloy Mark II engineering console. So we can drop that in. Which gives us a nice boost to our kinetic damage resistance and all energy damage resistance. AoE phaser damage. No, I will give that to her. Okay. Coles will get this. I think that's good. Yeah. That is good. Space dock. So we will just do this very quickly. I'll hand in the mission. Probably get promoted. Probably get an offer of a new ship, which we will deal with in the next episode. I think we're getting a new ship. I'm not certain. I love this game. I just love this game. It's so fun. And it feels like Trek. It genuinely does. Here we go. They've changed this since the last time I played, at least to some degree. Actually, it looks like they've changed it quite a bit. Admiral Quinn. Saurian Tactical Officer. And you are? Welcome to our space dock. How can I help you? Admiral's office. Where is Admiral Quinn? Once you go down the ramp on your left, turn left, go down the curved hall to ops, and in the next room you should see Admiral Quinn. You can usually find Shiro Sugara and Captain Sulu in the ops as well. Seriously, Sulu's? I wonder which Sulu it is, because I don't remember there being a Sulu in this game. Oh, that's nice. This is new, the navigation beam. Awesome. They have changed this quite a lot. I don't see no Sulu here. Alright, let's talk to this guy. Greetings, Lieutenant. Admiral Sir Katambi reporting. We have a lot to discuss, Cadet. Cadet Katambi, it's Lieutenant, sir. I see that here in the report transmitted by Captain Volok. He granted you field promotion to give you seniority over the rest of the active crew of your ship. As a cadet, you were assigned to an academy training cruise under Captain Masked Taggart, correct? Acting First Officer. Yes, sir, that's correct. I've read the reports facing off against Klingon Raiders and a Borg invasion force within hours of leaving Starfleet Academy. Very unusual. In your own words, tell me what happened out there. Explain what happened. That's quite a story. Yes, sir, it's all true. Don't worry, I have statements from Captains Volok, Yim, and Villa Post from the Vega Colony corroborating your story. I think that's just bad localization. All three of them cite your bravery and command skills, as well as you and your crew's willingness to put yourselves in harm's way to preserve the lives of others. I'm a Starfleet officer, sir. It's in the job description. and you're exactly the kind of officer Starfleet needs. I know your ship might not be the Enterprise, no, it's not, but I think you've proven capable of sitting in her captain's chair. Sir? Under normal circumstances, it would take you years of work to get your own command, but these are not normal circumstances. We are at war with the Klingon Empire, the Borg have returned, I'm losing more trained officers and ships that I can spare. Ships we can build, but leaders with courage and honor, and those are harder to find. It's time to try something different. I need someone who can handle themselves in a crisis and get the best out of their crew. Even though you're young, I think you're that person. I hereby promote you to the rank of lieutenant and give you command of the USS Charon. Don't disappoint me. You won't regret this, sir. No, but I am sorry for the loss of Captain Taggart, sir. Captain Taggart was a good man and a fine officer, lieutenant. He knew what he was doing when he issued that order. Don't dwell on what happened. Your actions saved the lives of your crew, not to mention the civilians you were able to evacuate from Vega Colony. Now it's up to you and your crew to honor Taggart's sacrifice as you carve out your own legacy. Do you have any further questions, Lieutenant? What's going to happen to Vega? Unfortunately, the Renown and her task force were not able to repel the Borg. Vega is lost. Starfleet Command will meet President Enik Okeg and the Federation Council to determine our next steps. For now, Starfleet vessels will patrol the outskirts of Vega's system to ensure no Borg escape. Do you have any further questions? What are your orders, sir? Welcome to Space Dock. Okay. You will be assigned to the Klingon front, but first you could use some new equipment for the Charon. I have some improved consoles developed by a Starfleet Corps of Engineers. These consoles can be installed to your ship to improve its capabilities. As you improve in rank, you will earn better consoles. Other ships you will command throughout your career will have space for many more. And when you're done here, go see Durs Rax to customize your starship's appearance. Ooh. One free starship modification. I may actually keep that, because I don't know. Phaser Relay Mark 1. Nice boost to damage. That means I can replace one of my ship's shields or phaser emitters. Nice. Good luck, Lieutenant. And we're going to leave it there. I'll level up and then start on the next episode. Oh, he's Trill. Okay, sorry about that. I'll level up in the next step at the start of the next episode, and we'll look at starship modification and what have you. That was enjoyable. I really liked that. So I hope you liked it too. And if you did, please like, share, and subscribe. It really helps with prioritizing search engines and what have you. But also, it gives me a reason to keep going and to keep really pushing with the series and other series. So I hope you have a really great day, and I'll talk to you all again soon. Bye, Pinkskins.